It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. B.J. Palmer, president of the Palmer School of Chiropractic in Davenport, Iowa. He is the only son of D.D. Palmer, the founder of chiropractic. Dr. Palmer has developed the principles and practice of chiropractic and is recognized the world over as the foremost authority on chiropractic. His subject is the scientific progress of chiropractic. Dr. Palmer.
The story of chiropractic is simple. Its birth was simple, the principle is simple, the practice is simple, results are just as simple to understand and to attain. The first chiropractic adjustment was given in 1895 to a man of impaired hearing. My father, D.D. Palmer, observed a subluxation in this man's spinal column. He decided to restore this subluxated vertebra to its normal position. The miraculous improvement which resulted from the adjustment of this vertebral subluxation led to patient diligent research and investigation. Two theories were advanced. First, that a vertebra in the spinal column could be subluxated and could be adjusted by hand. Second, that this subluxation could interfere with an abstract mental impulse flow of energy, and when the vertebra was adjusted, it restored this flow of energy between brain and body. Results secured in many cases, together with careful research and clinical practice, substantiated the fundamental truth of these theories. But until the discovery of the X-ray and the invention of the neurocalometer, it was not possible to prove the principles and practice of chiropractic by the use of scientific methods. The discovery by the German physicist Röntgen of the X-ray made it possible to prove the subluxation of vertebrae, that the segments of the backbone could be and were out of alignment before an adjustment, and that they could be and were realigned by chiropractic adjustment. This fact took the vertebral subluxation and its existence out of the field of theory and put it into the field of science. With the use of the X-ray, the chiropractor produces a picture of the spinal column called a spinograph. The spinograph is a photographic film on which has been cast a shadow of the spine, much the same as a shadow of a hand is cast on the wall. The spine shadow on the film gives the minute detail on the parts of the patient's spine. When measured at different points, the movable parts compared, the accurate size of the exit of the nerves from the spinal cord between the parts of the backbone are seen, showing the decrease from normal size of exits or holes, causing a pinching of the nerves, which creates pressure on such nerves and thereby interferes with the transmission of vital energy between the brain and various parts of the body. The discovery of the X-ray made it possible for chiropractors to scientifically prove the existence of vertebral subluxation. Then came the invention of the neurocalometer by D.D. Evans. Chiropractic contends that dis-ease is lack or excess of function in any organ or part of the body, and that all bodily function is controlled by the brain, which generates the vital energy within the individual, carried by the nerves to the organs, muscles, and tissues of the body. Naturally, when interference occurs to the transmission of this vital nerve energy between the brain and the body, heat is manifested at points of interference. The neurocalometer is a scientific instrument designed to detect very minute temperature differences along the spine. It locates accurately the points of spinal nerve interference. It makes a comparative heat reading registered through the medium of a thermopile and a galvanometer. The use of the neurocalometer enables the chiropractor to determine the points of nerve pressure in the spine, and after chiropractic adjustments have been given for releasing such pressure, further use of the instrument provides accurate knowledge as to whether the nerve pressure has been released and in what degree. The second fundamental theory of chiropractic, the existence of mental impulse interference, has been established as a scientific fact. Chiropractic is no longer the practice of theoretical principles. These have been established as scientifically demonstrable facts by the use of scientific equipment. Consult a chiropractor in your community who will give you the best chiropractic health service possible by the use of the X-ray and the neurocalometer.